Hello and welcome, I'm Stormo. Let's keep on with it.
When she was a babe, my daughter loved animals. Saw a deer trophy on a wall once. Did I what she asked?
Haven't got a clue.
Papa, is that deer's wump on the other side of the wall? You see it there? What's a trophy? I pity any bastard who's hurt her. I'll flay him alive. Here it is. Damn it! Jammed again.
Bedchamber. Tamara's room is there.
Okay.
Try not to make a mess. For their return, I want everything to be as they left it.
Wooden candlestick. Stem's broken.
Okay, so yeah, gonna be probably a bit of a shortish episode today. So, I feel like I shouldn't take anything out of the chest. I mean, it's totally fine too, but...
Fresh flowers. He expects them to return any minute. Takes hope.
But yeah, What else was there? Is that a thing? Nope. It's going to be one of those switching in and out of Witcher senses things.
Wall's a different color. Something used to hang here. That painting? Right size.
Hang on, which painting? Where was the painting? Oh, that painting. Let's see.
The Baron and his wife. Look happy enough. What's this? Gotta wonder who wanted to hide the hole. And what's on the other side.
Well, surely what's on the other side is just this cabinet. But, this cabinet? Ugh.
It gets interesting. Piece of wood looks like the stem of that candlestick. No coincidence there. Fight might have happened here. I'll look for clues.
Okay, yeah. Getting some slight jank with the camera angles at the moment, but should be good. But yeah, as I said, probably going to be a fairly short episode. Probably won't be much more than doing this and a few other bits and pieces just for this one, so...
Deep nicks. Hit with a heavy object.
And as I said, the game is behaving a little bit jankily, so I'm not sure what that's about.
Rest of the candlestick. And wine stains. Somebody smashed a bottle. From Toussaint. Yeah. Erveluce. Scent hasn't died. Wonder where it'll lead me.
Well, there we go. I was about to say, probably out of this room. And...
Get out of my sight.
Stuck on things. We didn't look in the kids' bedroom yet, but we may not need to.
Damn, trail breaks off. Could find something else, though.
Oh, hang on. Yeah, we did.
Spruce wood. Smells of juniper incense. Some sort of folk talisman. Protective. Question is, against what? Won't find much else here.
Yeah, so we ended up not finding anything in the other room. You can investigate. There are things in there, but I didn't go there.
Done poking around.
Found signs of a fight in the room. Know anything about that?
A fight? What are you talking about?
Someone was attacked. Probably your wife or daughter. Whoever it was tried to defend themselves with a candlestick. Missed the attacker. Punctured the wall instead. They tussled too.
I don't know nothing about this. That night, I was drunk. Don't remember a thing. They were gone by the time I awoke.
Doubt you were the only ones in the castle. Maybe one of your men heard something?
3 times I asked those bastards if they'd seen anything, heard anything. Nothing! Not a one of them!
Whole landing smells of wine. Tell me anything about that?
One of the lads, must be. Lushies, one and all.
Give your men Ervalus?
Oh, damn it. I might have spilled it. I told you I was good and marinated that night. Was it matter? Stench of wine in plenty of corner around the castle.
Recognize this amulet?
Yes. Anna began wearing it a time ago.
Any idea where she got it?
None.
Any witches or cunning women in the area?
A Pella. Old Coot lives near Blackbow. And there's a cunning woman in Midcops, but I know little about her. She's only recently arrived. If Anna were to see someone, she'd choose the Pella, not the woman. Anna was wary of strangers, newcomers.
Ought to have a chat with this Pella.
Fair warning, he's a hard man to talk to. Rumour has it he killed his own father with an axe as a lad, then went batty. Now they say he sees ghosts and ploughs his goat.
Not really interested in his hobbies. Just want to ask about the amulet.
Okay, so it looks like we're off to find the Pella's hut. I can't remember if you actually did find anything in here, if you had a look, but we can just have a quick gander in here, just in case there was anything worth looking at. It's that, which is a letter to Tamara, which I suppose we could have a quick look at. And am I right in suggesting there's things in this cupboard? Ooh, hello.
Incense. And an old key. Wonder what it unlocks.
And whatever's in here.
Anise. Sandalwood. And something else. Saffron.
Wonder if it unlocks this. No. Okay, so we've got another smell to follow out of this room. But I'm not sure if this is the smell that will lead us... If this just leads... Nope, Trick. This leads us out. Okay. So we'll keep following this. Because... It was a good thing I decided to just on a whim go in that room, wasn't it? So I'll just keep following the smell. And quickly save the game. While we're at it.
Well, bring out the gimp.
Take the gimps.
Well, I guess you'll just have to go and wake him up now, won't you?
I forgot that. The whole thing about the gimp, if you've never seen it, is a reference to a movie called Pulp Fiction, which is a pretty well-known movie, but yeah. And it's verbatim from that movie. Hello.
An altar. So, the Eternal Fire's made it to Velen.
Well then, what about that note? Let's have a look at the...
An altar.
Ah, so don't stand on it.
Fire's made it to Velen.
I think while we're here, there's something else we can do. I'm just going to have a quick look and see if I can find a certain person, or is she not here specifically? She may not be specifically here. Might be around here, maybe? No. I was looking for someone that I don't think is here. Anyway, that's all good and well. So, maybe she's in here. No, that's not her.
To puke or not to puke, that is the...
that's not her. We're going to talk to someone while we're here, and I just want to see if I can find her. I think I have to go up a floor to find who I'm looking for, so we'll do that. I think she's on this floor. So, let's have a wander down here.
Little prick.
The game's telling us to go this way anyway if we want to get out. So, there's a stash here too. That's useful. But that's not what we're looking for. This is what we're looking for, I think. Need to go in here. And there she is.
Thistle. Shenanaking.
So, you're Gretka.
I am. And you're Geralt.
How do you know?
Because you've white hair and a medallion shaped like a wolf. Ciri told me about you.
You and Ciri talked a bit, didn't you?
We did.
Did she say where she was going, or what she came here to look for?
She said she was looking for you, and a sorceress. but you're here, so I guess she didn't find you. I wonder if she helped that friend of hers.
Ciri wanted to help a friend? Any idea who it was?
What do you mean, who? Her friend! She said he was in trouble and that she had to save him.
Do you know where Ciri is?
No. One day I bought her breakfast and she was already gone. The Baron told me she'd left.
Didn't ask where she'd gone?
I did. But he said I was too little and I wouldn't understand. But Ciri left me a gift.
A gift?
Yes, this. A green stone.
Beautiful as gifts go. Hide it well. Don't show it to anyone. It's worth a lot. Thanks, Gretka. Have fun.
But I'm not playing. I'm helping. Gonna kill the monsters. All of them.
Gretka's cool. She's just she doesn't do much, aside from being involved in that cutscene with Ciri and that sort of plot that we've just done there. She doesn't do a whole lot.
Time to water the horses.
So, but, you know, she's a cool little character to talk to. I think she does have a bit more dialogue later on, too, so have to remember to head back to her at some point. I suppose late night in the smithy's kind of empty, but there is a smithy here, and we should actually meditate till morning, because we do want to talk to the blacksmith. So I'm going to find just somewhere to meditate. This should do. I don't know why I need to find a place, because you can just, like, do it. I'll meditate till about there, and it should set us to morning. Near enough as makes no difference. There we go. And the blacksmith should be out and about. Oh, where is he? There's a peasant. Or is the blacksmith? Oh, the blacksmith's down there. I've missed him. Oh, that's right. I was seeing that on the map. Okay. Yeah, no. The blacksmith I'm looking for is down here. We need to have a chat to this guy. I mean, we don't need to, but we will.
What? How may I assist you?
Looking for someone who can craft me some armor. Gotta be top quality.
Well, I've been at it 20 years now. Mastered the craft in some respects, if I do say so myself.
You wish.
Don't listen to her. She's been sore lately, snorting every chance she gets. So, what kind of armor are we talking about?
Light, but durable. Can't constrain movement, and I gotta be able to get in it without anybody's help.
That all? Sure it shouldn't be self-cleaning. And how about it wipe your arse after you take a shite in the bushes?
Comfortable, strong, and light'll do just fine.
Ought to know one thing when it comes to armor. If it's got to be durable, it can't be light.
It can. Just needs the proper tools to make it. Tools like the folk of Clan Tordaroch use on Undvik.
Joanna, I told you time and again to stay silent when I talk to customers. Shouldn't pester folk with those nonsense Skellige legends of yours.
It ain't legend, and it ain't nonsense. My granddad would go to Undvik for his armor. Said Tordaroch folk made the best. Till last year, that is, when a giant ravaged their island. Inhabitants either ran off or died, but the forge should still be in one piece.
Worth looking into. Say I find the tools. Will you craft the armor for me?
On condition you bring the tools. But only then.
These legends mention where the forge might be?
Yes. North side of the isle, in a cave. Clan folk carved out a rock face to build it.
Look for the tools next time I'm in Skellige. Take care now.
How can I help you?
Interesting lilt in your voice. You originally from Skellige?
Ard Skellig. Spent my whole childhood in Holmstein.
Why'd you leave?
Always had a liking for the smithy. I'd sit there all day taking things in. The heat of the furnace, the smell of the hot steel, the pounding hammers. At 17 winters, my dad told me he could teach me no more. Sent me out there into the world, bid me to hone my craft. A few years on, I had my master crafting papers. Then the war broke out and I landed here.
Take care now.
So, There's actually more to that story. Is that Roach? That's not Roach. That's not even a horse I can mount, I don't think. Where is Roach, actually? Oh, while we're here. Let's grab the notice board. So we've got the local Fist of Fury quest now too, so that's where that gets picked up. And the Velen Gwent quest. I'm skipping most of the Gwent stuff just because it's so much extra time. Probably won't do a lot of the races, but probably will do the Fist of Fury quest at some point. So for the moment we will head out. And we'll head to the Culler's Heart, actually, while we're here. So I'm going to walk out and then summon our good friend Roach. I'll do that. And just quick save the game while we're here. Here we go. So, as I said before, it was a little bit pushed for time today, so which has been happening a lot lately, I know. I'm going to try and find a time. What I need to do is find a time to record a whole batch of episodes, and I can make them not so much long episodes. I want to keep the length around half an hour, which I'm going to aim for with this episode as well. But in general, I'm trying to keep the length around half an hour, but I want to record a whole batch at once just to get sort of continuity with the play, because it helps me if I've played and I remember what I was up to immediately. And also, this game is just a game that I find it hard to put down a lot of the time. When I stop playing it, after playing it for half an hour, I'm like, man, I wish I'd been able to play more, so. But yeah, we're doing okay. I've still got to find that other, oh, that's one of the horse races, too. We've still got to find that other religious idol at some point, too, that's been knocked over somewhere around. I think it's further south-ish? I'm not entirely sure, but yeah. We'll get to it. That's one of them, but that one hasn't been knocked down, has it? That's actually the first one we encountered.
Go, go.
So I'm not sure where the third one is. I could track the quest, I suppose, and just ride to it, but it's one of those quests we can do while we're doing all this other stuff. So we come to Blackbow, which we're not actually heading to. We're going straight through today, so make the right choice about the road out of the town, which is this road that we want to be on. Well, we could have done it either way, apparently. Still. Oh boy. Have I been dudded by the GPS? I've been dudded by the GPS, haven't I? Yeah, we're going to have to, I think, come around. I want to do that in a way that isn't going to get me caught by those wild wolves. Let's run. I got dudded by the GPS, that's what I get for trusting it. So we'll head across here. There's this small path we needed to be on here.
Come on, Roach.
Okay, now we've got it. So that was a bit annoying. Here we go. This is what we need to do. So we'll,
what do you want?
Want to talk to the Peller.
Too late. We've got dibs on a chat with him. A long one.
I wonder if this will work. Hang on, let's start.
What do you want from him?
To give him what he deserves.
And that is?
He done conjured auguries. Said something evil had made its nest in Edric's bowels. Told Edric to eat rowan berries. Lots of them.
Ever since Edric's lived in the outhouse. And he's got hardened pustules all over him.
So we could either do this, or we could just do this.
Just so happens I need the Peller alive. So if you agree to leave him alone, for good, I'm willing to tell you how to help Edric.
Well, all in all...
Yes or no?
Fine. Let's hear it.
A tea of mullein leaves for his belly, and cover his boils with mallow. A few days and he'll be good as new.
Noted. But if it don't work, we'll be back. Move out, boys.
I think that's one of those situations...
Gotta wonder about a man who could get Edric's friends all worked up.
I think... what was I gonna say? that's one of those situations where if you do use the Axie sign, it actually doesn't work.
Hey, anybody home? Open up, it's safe now.
Devils, who do they bring? What seek ye?
I need your help.
Whoa, a man, nay, a wolf, grey, though not old. Tis he the pillar awaits.
You were expecting me.
Aye, as the bones declared I should. They shall come whose stench is rape and death, but the wolf shall disperse them, the white wolf. And thus he comes. Omens never lie.
Recognize this? Made of spruce wood, strong smell of juniper, designed to protect someone.
Freshly cut spruce, sprinkled with goat's blood, then tempered with an incense of earth, smoke, and juniper. For Anna, to protect her.
You make the amulet?
Aye, sure 'twas the Pella. After the way of his forefathers, over still water in the light of a full moon. Proper as amulets go. It protected well. Should never have taken it off.
So, designed to protect her. From what?
Oh, the dear. Besieged she was. Evil all around, wanting to possess her. Old magic, born of oblivion, from dark sources emerged.
Old magic? Can you be more specific?
Tis not for mouth speech, nor for the touch. A small protective charm, not a thing more a Pella could do.
Anna and her daughter are missing. Know where they are?
Nay, no, nay. Pella don't know. But the spirits could know. The Pella will augur, the spirits ask.
Spirits? Great. Fine with me. Long as I know where to look, where to find them.
Lost, must be found. Princess! None better than princess for finding things.
Princess? Which princess?
Princess, my goat! She's fled!
Those men must have scared her off. Can we get back to the auguring?
Without the goat, impossible. No goat? Won't work.
Will you help me if I bring the goat back?
Princess! Princess! Where have you got to, girl?
Fine. I'll get your goat.
The bell! The little bell's ringing! She loves it! Ring, ring, and she will follow. Look for a while. But beware of wild strawberries. Raspberries, too.
Yeah, treacherous as beasts go. I always keep an eye out for them.
Yeah, so, the Pella is, an interesting character, certainly. Gotta find this goat. So, oh boy, there's a lot of things in this wood, too. Should probably quick save. Because there's a lot of things that aren't, shall we say, alive. Well, aren't good for our health, I suppose is the best way to put it. Oops. Didn't actually mean to use the sign there. In fact, I wouldn't be using the sign in this circumstance anyway, I'd be using it. Oh, yeah, that's right. Ring the bell, can't we? If that's the thing we want to do.
Damn, you're ugly.
But yeah, so the Pella is just another aspect of the, interesting. Oh, hello. Is that the sound of a goat I heard then? It's honeysuckle, grab that too. I didn't notice the sound of a goat, but I did see these.
This way, I think.
Yeah, I can hear the goat.
Another clue.
Trying to remember if the sound of the goat is spatially arranged. There we go. We found
there
it.
You are.
So,
Here, goat. Here, princess.
Oh, come on, really?
Hoofed and horned. Should have known it would be stubborn. All right, time to try the bell. Come on, let's go see the Peller. Should have guessed as much. What's a witcher compared to a patch of wild strawberries? Come on, damn it. This way, Your Grace. Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow?
Geralt is none too happy about finding this goat, by the way. If it wasn't obvious from his very sarcastic reply before, he is not pleased about this. We're gonna go this way.
Where the hell do you go?
The good news is that we've killed most of the... Bloody hell. The goat is annoying as hell, by the way. Oh, that's right, we've got to defend the goat.
Bear! Bear! Run, you stupid piece of
There we go. That was easy. Even though I lost a whole bunch of health. Use one of my potions, actually. Let the goat go. Come here, goat.
Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow?
Yep, we do, Geralt. It's annoying as hell, but it's how the goat works. Good thing we killed all those wolves, hey? Gotta make sure she's behind us on the minimap. I think the bear's the only threat. The wolves are a threat if you don't kill them first. But I think the bear is the only thing we actually have to worry about on the way back.
You're no roach, but I bet we can be friends in time. You've got that all-important quality every roach has to have. You don't talk much.
Princess! Flee not from the Peller, for there are wolves nowhere in sight. Goat of mine, dearest, sweetest goat.
Can we talk about Anna and Tamara now? Know where they might be?
Blood. We need blood. A living being.
Fine. Be right back. This do? It's over? Is that it?
That is it.
Spirits had nothing more to say? Like where they went or where they are now?
You came for an augury, and augur I did. They're gone, the child remains.
Mentioned a child. Whose?
Why, Anna's.
Anna was pregnant?
She was. And she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps. Or ashamed, or forgetful. Or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
Anna tell you all this? Did she come here after it happened?
Nay, not Anna. 'Twas the omens told me.
Great, so I can be sure it's true.
The omens need not your faith to be true. It is you who needs the omens to lead you to truth.
The Baron have anything to do with his wife's miscarriage?
Foul-tempered he is, and he's a fondness for hooch.
No doubt makes his temper even fouler. Did he abuse his family? Anna came to you, you must have noticed something.
The Pella's old, near blind. But Princess came and licked her hand.
So what?
She's a wise beast. Only comes to those who suffer.
What happened to the child?
In a grave thrown, without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders, it seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
White wolf, wise wolf, catch the botchling. The botchling will help. Lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
'Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the white wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood. Blood will always find kindred blood.
Why do you want its blood?
Blood, blood, blood. It binds men for all ages, the living and the dead.
Sure, but what do you want to do with it?
At times, a century is too short for two brothers to reconcile. One dies before things are set right. The other then brings his blood to the Pella.
Mm-hmm. And what does the Pella do?
He awaits Forefather's Eve. He mixes the blood with milk, herbs, and hen's feet. He drinks to reconcile the dead with the living. There shall be no Forefather's Eve this year. But we'll find a way, all the same.
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming? That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
I hear you right. You mentioned Forefather's Eve. Pretty old custom. Thought it had died out.
Death lurks in every bog and puddle round here. Folk know they could die, their earthly matters unresolved. Then they require help, or they'll not know peace. Forefather's Eve must be performed. Light the tallow candles to lead them through the dark. Call them by name, appease their regrets. Only then may they depart in peace.
Whatever I do, I gotta find the botchling first.
Seek it at midnight, near the grave that lies empty.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.
Oh yeah. Oh boy. The botchling. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. That's a fun one. And it's a fun one we're gonna do in the next episode, because I am really not feeling dealing with the botchling. There are a lot of really grotesque things in this game, but the botchling stands out quite severely, and if you're unfamiliar with it, you'll get to see it in all its glory in the next episode. And if you are familiar with it, you already know exactly what I've got to go through very shortly, because it's a fun quest. But yeah, the botchling is not pleasant. And in fact, the next episode's going to be pretty dark, because this whole Baron storyline is actually pretty tragic as we get further and further into it. But I won't say too much more than that. But yeah, just don't expect happy times, at least for the next couple of episodes anyway. We're going to leave it there, so thank you all for watching, and I will see you all next time.